Hi everybody, it's Joni Young here. Thanks for joining me today for this painting tutorial. Today I'm going to be using turquoise, black, and white on 6x6 inch acrylic painting paper. So just a limited palette today and a few different brushes. So follow along with me step by step in this fun landscape painting tutorial. The first brush I'm going to be using is a number 10 flat brush. First thing you want to do is get that brush just a little bit wet. I'm going to take all three colors, but more of my turquoise than the white or the black. So turquoise first, a little bit of black and white, and I'm going to start coming down diagonally in the middle from one corner, the left corner, to the bottom right corner. Short little brush strokes, back and forth. I'm going to leave the top right corner white, and then I'm going to go in to a little bit more of my white and black, tinted with a little bit of that turquoise. So more on the gray side here. And I'm going to start working where I left off on the left side, down to the bottom left corner. Now once I get that all covered, I'm going to wash my brush out, make sure it's still a little bit wet. And then I'll take a little bit more of my black paint, just black this time. I'm going to place my brush right on the bottom left, pull and flick up very gently to create an instant looking forest. I'm going to make those brush strokes a little bit shorter to create perspective, and then pull a little skinny line in between, and that will give us that instant reflection and make it look like water. And that's just the beginning stages of our forest. Now the next step, you want to make sure your brush is all clean, rinse it out very well, have just a little bit of water in it. Then you're going to take some white, and it can be tinted with a little bit of the gray and a little bit of turquoise, or just straight white if you want. And starting from the corner, the top right corner, diagonal brush strokes for our sun rays. So place your brush right on the top right corner and pull and gently flick towards the trees. Now, if you're having any trouble doing this, just take a little bit of water and a little bit more paint, but you need both in your brush to create this brush stroke and make it look nice and see-through and soft looking. Time for our next brush. This one's a number 4 filbert, and if you want, you can use something just a little bit bigger or even smaller. Make sure it's a little bit wet. I'm going to take both black and turquoise and make a nice deep muted turquoise color here to start. Just mix it up, get it loaded up on the tip of your brush. Mainly the tip of your brush is where you want to be loading that paint. And then gently pull and flick little brush strokes here to create a bit more perspective, making some of those layers of trees a little softer looking than the black we initially added at first. This is just a way of creating depth and layers in a landscape. Now taking black, pulling up a line, and you can make your tree as tall as you want. And then I'm just going to start tapping in lightly, smaller little taps for those little branches that go towards the top of the tree. And then I'll gently and gradually start making them a little bit bigger and wider by pushing more on my brush, just applying pressure. So decreasing pressure and adding pressure will give you the size and fullness that you want. And what I'm going to also do is just alternate my colors. So I'm going to create darker shades, lighter shades, just by adding a little bit more turquoise or less black or more black. And each one of my trees is going to be a different shade, but using all of the same colors that we have here, which is just this limited palette of turquoise, black, and white. Now I want to mention the turquoise that I'm using today is Bright Aqua Green by Liquitex Basics Acrylic. The black I'm using is just a thinner, it's not a heavy bodied one. It's one of my craft paints that I have. And just because it's a little bit easier to blend around with on this painting paper. And I've also got titanium white. Now you can use any color that you want or anything similar to this. So I'm going to just overlap now and start adding some highlights and some more layers here with a turquoise over top of the black. And I'll do this a few times, alternating, like I said before, with a black, white, and turquoise. Sometimes lighter, sometimes darker. And just by doing this, you really do create the layers leading up to foreground, more trees in the foreground, and that'll instantly put some trees in the background. So by making darker and lighter shades and different height, will all create that perspective and that layered look, giving you the depth that you want for a really dramatic landscape. With a clean brush, I'm going to take a little bit more black now, and I'm going to start coming in with a little line right here, right underneath where those trees are, and then gently pulling and flicking down in the opposite direction as I did for the trees above. This way you just get that nice gentle reflection, just a little bit, nothing too mirrored. We want it to be a little bit more blurry and just more about shadow and reflection. I'm going to come in with a lower case tree here, so we've got the taller ones now in the distance right behind, and the same technique, so just pulling a little line and then turning your brush the other way to create all the little branches and foliage. So I'm going to come in and layer another tree right in here, and this one I'm going to use a little bit more black. And again, just by using the very tip of my brush, the very end of it, gentle brush strokes and tapping, you can create some awesome looking branches. The filbert brush is what I love to use for painting trees because I feel like I have a bit more control over it than using a fan brush, but you can use either one. You can also use a round brush or even a liner brush. There's a lot of options out there, and I've got quite a few tutorials demonstrating different brushes, different techniques to create different trees. So lots out there for you guys to have a look at. Just check out the playlist below or on my channel. So another layer here, smaller trees, and now over to my mini liner brush. Now this brush, I just got in a whole set of these. These are actually for nail art, and I know that they use only the best in nail art, and I knew that I wanted this for my paintings. So look outside the box sometimes when you're looking for brushes. I'll leave a link below for these as well. They're wonderful. So micro mini liner brush here, and I'm just adding a few more little details that I can't quite do with my filbert brush. So just the tops of the trees, a little bit more delicate looking branches and treetops. Okay, now once I've done that, I'm going to switch back over to my number 4 filbert white and add another layer over top of my sun rays. So if you happen to pick up a little bit of gray or black like I did there, I had a little drop that I didn't notice. Don't worry about it. It's going to add more depth later on when you add some more white over top. And you can also just go over it right away or gently brush it off with just a little bit of water. So I'm kind of just blending it out here with a bit of water and a little bit more white, and you're still left with a light tinted gray here, which ends up looking quite beautiful later on once the painting is all done, because it does add a little bit more depth and possibly some shadows and soft looking clouds beneath the bright white sunlight and rays. And so you'll see how that develops throughout the rest of this painting tutorial. I added a little bit of a highlight to soften a part of the water. It's nice to have those in-between tones, so your darkest black and then the gray and then the turquoise and then the turquoise and the black and the white and bright white. So I'm using a little bit more black right here. I'm going to define my staircase now and just start coming in right down towards the bottom with black, making those lines start to curve and go towards those sun rays, where those sun rays and that light is coming from. That's really what helps to draw us into this painting, and it makes it so inviting. And then I'm gonna add white for the highlight, and then that really helps to make this look 3D. So the light and the shadow and that contrast are all what you need to make something look 3D and keep it from looking flat. Now I've got a little flat brush here that I want to mention I'm using. This is a number 4 flat brush. You can do this with a filbert brush too if you don't have a flat. I think that flat is the best option for painting stairs because unless you're working on like stone paths, something that has rounded edges to it, then I would recommend and lean more towards a filbert brush. But the flat brush will give you nice straighter lines and edges for painting something like this, these little stairs. So I'm just gonna continue up here tapping and pulling and creating that depth and shadow and overall just the shape and the curve and the direction I want the staircase leading up into and how small I want the stairs to get towards the end where they just start to disappear. So light little taps and then I'll gently soften and you see how I just kind of start to turn my brush and use the corner of it. So that it kind of just all becomes one and a light little line that, yeah, just disappears off into the sunlight there. Okay, now it's time to come in with our railing and I'm gonna be using my little liner brush again for this. And I'm gonna take a little bit of black first. So just black to start my lines and I want my railing to be bigger in the foreground, just like my stairs are. So you want to go and follow that perspective. So bigger to smaller. So you just see how it kind of starts to trail off in the distance and I start tapping closer together until it just disappears with those stairs. But here in the foreground, I'm taking my time and going carefully, gradually making them smaller and spacing them apart a little bit more. After I add the black for the first step for our railing, I'm going to come in with a white and follow on one side. Choose the side that makes sense that the light would be hitting. So for the left side of my staircase, I'm choosing the right side. And for the right side of my railing on my staircase, I'm choosing the right side as well. So the right side highlight and the left side shadow. So take a few minutes to kind of let that sink in so that it kind of makes sense for you. Because it sounds, as I'm saying this right now, it sounds a little confusing, but just it's got to make sense with that light. Otherwise, it just won't come together properly and it won't flow and won't look as nice. So you want to make sure that you get your highlights on the right side and only one side of the railing. And then I'll just define and come in with a little bit more black again. So I'll go around and just look at my railing and add a little bit more shadow, define, and then come in with a top handle there for the railing. So we've got our posts there and now the top of the railing. So I'm going to choose to add my railing right in the very top. And because I like to create ornate swirls in my paintings, I'm going to make them swirl at the very end here. And then I'll, of course, add a little bit of white and add highlight to the top where it would make sense that the light would be hitting. So this can be a little bit different and not as straightforward as knowing where to add the light on your little posts of your railings. So just follow along here. And I'm going more towards the right side here on the left of my railing. And then on the right side of my railing, I'm gonna just take that white and go right over top, leaving a bit of black underneath. So you could just be a little bit more careful with the posts on your railing, but with the top part of your railing, you can just be a little bit freer with that. And then back underneath, I'll clean this up and make sure that I have enough black showing really to make this stand out and look 3D. So as I'm adding more highlights and shadows here for a couple minutes with this brush, I'll just mention the paper that I'm using, which is quite different for me. You don't see a lot of tutorials and videos from me painting on paper. So the reason why I'm painting on paper is actually an accident. So I thought I was ordering my palette paper, which you see to the left that has all my paint on it. I was actually ordering painting paper, so I made a mistake and I received this two pads of painting paper. This is by Arteza and I really, really like it. Now it does buckle a little bit and that's the reason, main reason why I prefer to paint on canvas, because I have not found acrylic paper any paper to paint on that doesn't buckle, but this one buckles the least out of any paper that I've tried. And I will leave a link below for it because I do like this, and you're going to be seeing quite a few more tutorials from me using this paper because I have two pads and I'm kind of having fun with these mini paintings. And if you're enjoying mini paintings, I've got a whole playlist of them, but you can paint this on a larger size, whatever surface you're working on, whether it be rocks or canvas or paper. Any of my tutorials can be taken to any surface, and you can approach them using any medium, so watercolor, oil, gouache, and of course acrylic. Here on my channel I only use acrylic paints, but don't ever hesitate to follow along with one of my tutorials using the medium that you like. Now I'm going to come in with my liner brush again here, a little bit of black paint, and I'm going to add some simple birds that anybody can do. So you just want to do a little V and then add a little scoop and flick to the left and the right. And then I add a little fullness in the middle there for the body, but all very just suggestive. Just a little suggestion. This is very free. We're not out to paint every little detail of the bird. They're far away, and all you need is a basic little shape here. And even if you want to make it even simpler, just add a little V, so like the letter V, and make it skinnier on either side and a little thicker where it comes down in the point of the V, and just do a few of those different sizes, and then you'll just automatically have little birds in your painting that I think add so much and really helps to make this painting look even more peaceful and tranquil like and invoke some kind of calm mood. And it is inviting having the staircase much larger right down off the paper, so it makes you feel like you're standing there, and it's inviting and draws you in, makes you want to take a step up those staircase and see where it leads. Now I called this a stairway to heaven, and you can paint this in any colors that you want, pink, purple, don't have to, and you can even add another color. You can use turquoise and add other colors to this. So this is just one approach, but I encourage you guys to experiment and have fun and develop your own unique skills alongside what I'm teaching you here today. I'm adding a little bit of a highlight here, just a little dab here and there on part of the birds. So maybe they look a little bit more like they've got some sun rays hitting them. They could be seagulls, they could be doves, any kind of bird that you want them to be, and without adding too much detail. So I hope you guys are enjoying these tutorials I'm showing you lately that are a little bit more in depth. I've been taking my time more to be very thorough because I care about teaching you guys and giving you quality tutorials here on my channel. I want the best for you guys and your learning experience and your journey with learning to paint. I want to inspire you and be a coach for you here, and just help you develop your skills better and become a happier painter. Most importantly, to be a happy painter. So if you're ever feeling frustrated, remember it's okay. It's normal. Take a break. And don't ever give up and just keep going. So adding another layer, my final layer to my sun rays here. Now you might want to make sure that the rest of your painting is all dry. Now because I'm painting on acrylic paper, the paint soaks in quicker and it does dry a lot faster. So I didn't, in this case, have to dry my painting off first. But depending on what you're painting on, if you're painting on canvas, and acrylic paint does dry quicker in general anyways. Another thing I forgot to mention, if you're just new to acrylics, one thing you need to know that's really important and a lot of people don't talk about in their videos is that acrylic paint dries darker. So you may be a little bit surprised later on once your painting dries and wondering why it doesn't look the same. So keep that in mind. That's a little tip for you. And here I'm just gently peeling off the tape, leaving this nice white clean edge that I love so much. I'm going to sign my painting and call this one done. Be sure to look below for some more tutorial links for you and social media where you can follow me on all of those places, Facebook, Pinterest, Instagram, and Patreon. Have a wonderful day. please subscribe to my channel and hit that bell so you don't miss out on any of my future tutorials. See you soon, everybody. Bye.